spending more than this holiday dinner. Sometimes it's hard. There'll be multiple courses, multiple items. What interested me in this project is the core of this, the bottom line of this, is something that I've been preaching, gosh, for 10 years. And that is the nature of the way we eat. Now, let me stop there because you hear a lot about what we eat. You hear a lot about processing. You hear a lot about fast food. And all that's really true. And the problems that are associated with increasing obesity, increasing diabetes, and all the other health issues that are associated with primarily with processed foods. We define the nutritional value of processed foods and all that stuff. But one thing that health many really spends any time talking about is how it's amazing. And our culture, this country, is only unique because we can consume more calories in a nanosecond than most other cultures do in a week. It's absolutely phenomenal. And if, particularly if you look at the fast food stuff, you go to Arby's and one of their sandwiches, that's sandwich. No Coke, no fries, just the sandwich. Has almost 2,000 calories. Now, the problem, aside from the fact that it's 2,000 calories in one sandwich and you still have the rest of the day to eat, is you're pretty shallow. The nutrient value is almost nothing. But this is one of the problems that we've had is the way we eat. We eat on the run, we eat in the car, we eat everywhere. And we don't eat 3 meals a day, we eat constantly. No matter where we are, we get up, we start eating, and it's this way all day long. The family meal is gone away. There's so many other social problems that are related to that. And one I've been trying to do for a long time is to get people back to the diet. To use eating time not just for sustenance, but also for communication, for relationship. That's the way I grew up. my grandmother, years ago, many years ago, when I was going away to school and I had my own apartment, I went to see my grandmother before I left and we had breakfast. My grandmother was a very aristocratic lady. She had her process and very disciplined. She was by herself every morning. She prepared her breakfast. She went out on her little deck, the weather was decent. She went over there in the school corner and asked the questions. You know, she needed all the attention to not get mad. The night before, the soup spilled and dessert spilled and all that. There's always a can of rum. And that's the way she did that. And I went over there and she prepared breakfast and sat down to eat. She said, you know, I believe it's why you need a can of rum. But you know, sometimes when we live alone, we use our social places. 19 years old. And she started talking to me about the importance of treating me well. And she said, I know everyone wants to hear about me eating for whoever wants. She said, when it comes time to meal, I want you to clear everything off, put up the books, turn off the TV, you can leave the music on, the answering machine needs to be on, and you devote your time to that. And if possible, a little ornament like a candle or a flower. God, 19 years old, that's not going to happen. But I did what she said. I prepared my meals. Now, I did not eat regularly as I should have. I listened. That didn't dawn on me. But this is something that I grew up with. Now, she never said anything about eating in the car. That was a concept beyond her imagination. There were no cup holders. This is how old I am, guys. Yeah. I mean, there were no cup holders in my first album, which is a brand new dream. Yeah, right. A lot more muscle than I needed. And when the Japanese started marketing cars here in the United States, they had a hell of a time selling them. Because by this time, there were cup holders. But the Japanese didn't have cup holders. When they started putting cup holders in the cars, they started selling cars. Now, when they were selling them back in Japan, there were no cars. That was a concept that these people didn't understand. If you look at the history of cuisines around the world, you look at things that, if you are familiar with German cuisines, these are kind of popular. And the French are known for the amount of butter and cheese and things that they use. The amount of wine that they drink in Italy. Japanese are having problems. Until they import our own. When the Western culture starts to show up, the culture fades. It starts out with what they do. But what happens is the way they consume the Japanese. Yeah, this is not just my opinion, it's statistics and research. And the other thing about this, and those are all very practical things, but the deal is, why do we do these things that we have to do anyway and not enjoy them? You can't possibly enjoy wolfing down 2,000 calories in 45 seconds. There was an ad years ago, and I don't remember the TV, a Hungry Man TV ad, I think that's what it was. And the tagline was, it's good to be full. It's not good to be full, it's miserable. And then you walk around and go, oh man, I should, and why don't we do that? And we don't have to. And this is what I'm trying to do, is trying to show people it's not complicated to prepare good food. And it's really part of the enjoyment of life. And when you can start with what Bobby and you guys are just trying to do with your hands in the soil versus dirt. And watch this whole process, and then you have a different appreciation for it when you get into the kitchen. And then when you've done that and you sit down, this is something that you've created, and it's not a complicated thing, guys. We've been marketing today, and the language has changed. You're doing it. You slapped off so much stuff, and nobody has a clue. It sounds complicated and fancy and expensive. Gourmet simply means that you cared enough to start with the finest, freshest ingredients and prepare them the best way. If you look at the real culture, when Italians come over here and go to many Italian restaurants, it's totally foreign to America. We don't eat it. It's American tag. Italian cooking is very simple. French cooking. The classic French gets real formulated and really manipulated and things like that. But you get into conventional French cooking and it's entirely different. Bistro cooking in Paris is great. It's real simple. But the great thing is the quality of the product, the raw product, is what makes the difference. It doesn't have to be. I was in a restaurant with a family member about 5 years ago in Washington, D.C. called Iriki, an Italian restaurant. Incredible. There are two Irikis, one in Washington and one in Florence. The one in Washington prepares meals exactly the same way that they do in Florence. I don't know where they get the produce, the raw ingredients, but they are fresh. And I'm sitting with this lady, and we sit down, and she gets her main meal, and I hear this moaning, and she has this little hair on me. Eyes are like cinnamon. Took a bite. It's very simple. It's just simply sauteed in olive oil. That's it. Still has some texture to it. It's incredible. There you go. That's what it is. And this is what we learn when we go through and we have manipulated the seed source. Or the plants, or whatever we've done, is that as we've done this, we grow more and more food per acre. But the nutrition level has to find their statistical here again, we have to consume more and more calories and nutrient levels. And we don't need to consume more calories. 3 ounces of animal protein is not all we need. Appetizer, 16-ounce steak, loaded baked potato, salad, dessert, and then go home and eat 6 or 7 pieces of bread. And then, always a problem. What's going on in this afternoon? So my intent is, when we do these classes, is to do a little bit of that, talk to you about the importance of this, and give you a little bit of history behind whatever it is I'm doing. And it will be simple. It will be dependent upon what's it like, which is the way it should be. There will be simple preparations. There will be things that anybody can do. It may be something as simple as sauteed peppers and onions and all.